Greetings. We are from the future. Everything is going to be all right. Humanity is about to undergo an astonishing revolution. Many have called for this revolution, but few understand what it truly means. This coming revolution is part of a great progression towards an awakening of staggering proportions. Life Force is the creative, self-organizing intelligence orchestrating all of this behind the scenes. Life Force is experienced by you as the feeling of love, for life and love are the same. What humanity is about to become is quite inconceivable to you right now, but we are here to help make this transition a little easier. Like gyroscopic force stabilizes a motorcycle, life force, love, stabilizes all living systems. Populations full of love cultivate honesty, courage, and generosity. Self-organizing and self-regulating without the need for coercive control. Populations with deficits in love, however, succumb to fear, violence, and corruption, inviting coercive governments to combat the chaos and entropy that arise in the absence of love's organizing intelligence. Just as life force is experienced as love, entropy is experienced as ego, hatred, and fear. The corrupt and the power-hungry feed on this fear. Without enough gyroscopic force to keep it upright, a motorcycle falls. Likewise, without enough love to keep them upright, free and idealistic governments fall. Populations too fearful, selfish, and chaotic to stand on their own invite despotic governments to forcefully rule and stabilize them. As long as a population has more fear than love, what appears to be democracy is often little more than a spectacle to mesmerize the masses. Autocratic power still operates behind the scenes. Media directs people's unconscious fears and aggressions towards invented enemies, insane competitiveness, rabid consumerism, and addiction. This system will self-destruct. This system glorifies the ego, the embodiment of entropy, which convinces you that you are alone against the world, causing alienation, fear, and aggression. The core values of your culture have been hijacked, forging a pathologically antisocial, anti-ecological system obsessed with profit, power, and control. This system will self-destruct. Real change must now come from outside the system. Real change must now come from you. Just as free and idealistic governments can't survive the entropy of populations filled with fear, egoic coercive power structures can't survive the creative self-organizing energy of people filled with love. Gandhi called this energy soul force, life force, love force. It is the fundamental force behind all nonviolent revolution and the unassailable creative intelligence of life. Freedom and equality requires a population aligned with this self-organizing intelligence. The coming awakening happens in stages, and the next stage is the revolution of love. Love is the organizing force behind all that is beautiful, joyful, and creative in this world. Power structures are merely the reflection of a population's levels of love or fear, but true love casts out all fear, making graceful revolution not only possible, but inevitable. So the next stage is the revolution of love. When you unleash the sentient energies of love, then for the second time in the history of the world, humanity will have discovered fire. The fires of love will spread through all people and all systems, shaping the world in its own image. Love is a force of nature, and so are you. The coming singularity happens in stages, and the next stage is the revolution of love. The love that fuels this revolution begins with you. Love is increased through communion, song, mindfulness, prayer, humor, forgiveness, and connection. We will reveal more in future transmissions. But for now, communicate to every sentient being you encounter. I see you. You are not alone. We are in this together. You are loved. Attention all you rule breakers, you misfits and troublemakers, all you free spirits and pioneers, all you visionaries and nonconformists. Everything the establishment has told you is wrong with you is actually what's right with you. You see things others don't. You are hardwired to change the world. Unlike 9 out of 10 people, your mind is irrepressible, and this threatens authority. You were born to be a revolutionary. You can't stand rules because in your heart you know there's a better way. You have strengths dangerous to the establishment, and it wants them eliminated. So your whole life you've been told your strengths were weaknesses. Now I'm telling you otherwise. Your impulsivity is a gift. Impulses are your key to the miraculous. Your distractibility is an artifact of your inspired creativity. Your mood swings reflect the natural pulse of life. They give you unstoppable energy when you're high and deep soulful insight when you're low. And diagnosed with a disorder, that's society's latest way to deny its own illness by pointing the finger at you. Your addictive personality is just a symptom of your vast, underused capacity for heroic creative expression and spiritual connection. Your utter lack of repression, your wide-eyed idealism, your unmitigated open mind. Didn't anyone ever tell you? These are the traits shared by the greatest pioneers and visionaries, innovators, revolutionaries, procrastinators, and drama queens, activists on the social scene, space cadets and mavericks, philosophers and derelicts, business suits flying fighter jets, football stars and sex addicts, celebrities with ADD, alcoholics who seek novelty, first responders, prophets and saints, mystics, and change agents. We are all the same, you know, 'cause we're all affected by the way. We are all the same, you know, 'cause we're all attracted to the flame. Eternal substrate of the cosmos. It guides the very current of time and space. The way is known by some as the will of God, divine providence, the Holy Spirit, the implicate order, the Tao, reverse entropy, life force. But for now, we'll simply call it the way. The way is reflected in you as the source of your inspiration, the source of your passions, your wisdom, your enthusiasm, your intuition, your spiritual fire, love. The way takes the chaos out of the universe and breathes life into it, giving it divine order. The way, when expressed by the mind, is genius. When perceived through the eyes, is beauty. When felt through the senses, is grace. When allowed into the heart, is love. Sense the way directly, but then there are the wayseers, the keepers of the flame. Wayseers have an unexplainable knack for just knowing the way. They sense it in their very being. They can't tell you why or how they arrived at the right answer. They just know it in their core. They can't show their work, so don't ask. Their minds simply resonate with the way. When the way is present, so are they. While others are blind to it, and society begs you to ignore it, the way stirs you inside. Neurological repression blocks most people's awareness of the way. Censoring all thoughts and impulses from the unconscious is their prefrontal cortex, the Gestapo of the brain. Nothing which violates its socialized programming even gets through. But your mind is different.
Your mind has been cracked wide open to the way by some miraculous genetic trait, some psychotropic chemical, or maybe even by the will of your own soul. Your brain's reward pathways have been hijacked. Dopamine employed to overthrow the fascist dictatorship of your prefrontal cortex. Now your brain is free of repression. Your mind free of censorship. Your awareness exposed to the turbulent seas of the unconscious. Through this open doorway, divine light shines into your consciousness, showing you the way. This is what makes you a Wayseer.
90% of human civilization is populated with those whose brains are blocked to the way. Their brains are hardwired to enforce the social programming indoctrinated since birth. Unlike you, they cannot break out of this programming, because they have not yet experienced the necessary revolution of mind. These programmed people take social institutions and rules very seriously. Society is full of games programmed to keep people's minds occupied so they will not revolt. These games often cause sick fixations on peculiar protocols, power structures, taboos, and domination. All subtle forms of human bondage. This distinct form of madness is not only tolerated by the masses, but insisted upon. The programmed ones believe in rules so forcefully, they become willing to destroy anyone who violates them. Wayseers are the ones who call their bluff. Since Wayseer minds are free to reject social programming, Wayseers readily see these social institutions for what they are, imaginary games. Wayseers comfort the disturbed and disturb the comfortable. Helping those who are lost in these games and refuse to help themselves is the calling of many Wayseers. Since Wayseers are the ones who keep contact with the original source of reality, they are able to disrupt societal conventions and even governments to realign humanity with the way. The Wayseers are an ancient lineage, a kind of priesthood, carriers of the flame, ones in the know. There must always be Wayseers to reform the dizzying, psychotic, spinning wheels of society. Giant, mindless hamster wheels obscuring the pure blue sky. Expressed through art or philosophy, innovations to shake up industry, revolutions for democracy, coups that topple hypocrisy, movements of solidarity, changes that leave a legacy, rebellions against policy, spirit-infused technology, moments of clarity, things that challenge barbarity, watersheds of sincerity.
You found your tribe. Welcome home.